off-the-set interviews with the cast of Centurion A.D., and joining me now is Marc Elmer.
Hi, Alicia.
Hi, Marc. How are you?
I'm good. Good. How are you doing?
Great to have you today.
Thank you. What role
do you play in this upcoming movie?
I play Kevin, who is a young police officer who was killed in the line of duty. He is the husband of Kim, played by the lovely Catherine, so...
And so you said you're a police officer.
Yes.
And you're kind of killed early on, so yes. I guess this role for you is more of a supporting role then.
Yes, yes. Actually, when Brian originally called me about the film, he asked if I wanted to play Archer. And I said, I think I'm a little too attractive to play Archer. I don't want to outshine the rest of the cast. And
then he said, plus,
that's the hard thing about being as good looking as I am. And so he asked me if I wanted to play Aaron. I said, you're going to need a guy that's a little trimmer, not as buff as me. So I ended up casting the role of Kevin. I said, that I can do. Guy who's dead, trapped against the ceiling. Hang me from the ceiling and do that, I can do that.
That was a role that you naturally fit into.
That I can work with.
That's what you work with.
Absolutely.
So what did you draw on? Did you have anything to kind of inspiration to draw on to play this role? Or was it just kind of one of those natural, easy roles for you?
No, he could be me. I mean, for the most part, it's a married man who loves his wife very much. And the scene, I don't know that I ever even told Brian this, but he wrote the scene and he sent it to me and he said, I'd like you to play the role of Kevin. And I read the scene and I teared up. I was tearing as I was reading it. I was like, this is genius. This is very, very good. It's very heartfelt. It's like I said, a man who loves his wife very much, and this is his last chance to say goodbye.
Wow.
And
so this must be a tearjerker then.
The one moment in this film is incredibly heartfelt. There are many others, but this one really grabbed me, and I absolutely loved it. I loved the role. So.
Well, you know what? You're already probably luring in those moviegoers because when we hear you say it's a tearjerker. I mean, it definitely pulls at your heartstrings,
sure.
Makes you wonder, well, what happened? You know,
yeah.
what was that role like? So I guess in this role, needing to play this kind of tearjerker role, are you married? What did you have maybe to kind of draw on to really bring that role or scene to life?
Yeah, good question. As an actor, I mean, I since I'm married and I have little kids, I have a family, you know, I brought a lot of that into the role with me. And as I'm saying these words of goodbye, you know, I'm picturing in my head my own family, my wife, and what would it be like if I had to say goodbye to them? And that really, I mean, that's not hard to get there, honestly, when you've got that picture in your head, so.
So I take it that ended up being a pretty powerful role.
It was, and I hope it comes across on the screen the way that it felt inside. You know, I hope it plays.
I bet it will, because if you're already tearing up now, it tells me that that's going to be a good role.
Yeah, I hope so.
It's going to be a good scene, so I'm looking forward to it.
Good.
So since you were in the beginning part of the movie and then you come back toward the end, you're not going to give it away. So I guess did you have any other parts in the movie that maybe we can kind of look forward to, or is that pretty much it?
That was kind of my swan song. I have the moment where I get killed, that's sort of a flashback in the movie, and then the final scene.
The final scene.
And I think that pretty much speaks for itself, though. I mean, it says all it needs to be said.
Okay, so what made you want to be a part of this project? I mean, I know that there's... from talking with some of the other actors that you guys shot over the course of 14 months, a lot was involved in this. What made you say, okay, yes, I'm in?
Yeah, I've known Brian, the director, for years.
Okay, that helps.
Anything that he has done, I have wanted to be a part of. And so anything that he will do in the future, I will automatically sign on to, sight unseen, because I really feel like he has a genuine vision and he's got a real heart for the project. He knows how to talk to actors, being an actor himself. He knows what we go through, and you know, when we do roles, and he really has a good creative sensibility about him. He loves to bring a lot of fun to the set.
Okay.
He loves to bring creative ideas. I mean, he's sort of an auteur in the sense that he does visual effects, he does editing, he does DP work, he does directing, he does acting, he does everything.
Kind of like a one-man band.
He's got his hand in everything in a good way.
Everything.
You know,
okay.
He doesn't need to control everything. He's open to suggestions. So I really enjoy the process of working with him, and that absolutely draws me 100%.
So I bet, as you mentioned, it made the set fun.
It did.
Can
really
you kind
did.
Of give us an idea, what was it like on set then? If it's so much fun, makes me kind of want to know, what did you guys do?
Well, for my scene, they hung me from the ceiling, and there was three guys and a pulley and a rope and a harness and like. Get the image in your head. It was pretty spectacular. So. And we joke around a lot. We just have a lot of fun together. You know, it's not such a serious set where you come on and you immediately have to shh. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
was never like that. Never is on the projects with Brian.
Sounds like you guys had a good team camaraderie there.
Yeah, it was
a
really excellent group of people. There was not, I think I told Brian this, there's not a weak link in the cast. If there is, I'm probably it. I mean, you know, when they say,
if you
don't
know
who the weak link is, you're probably him. That's what I'm saying. So anyway, I just feel like it's an exceptional cast. Everybody really brings their A game. Really sharp people. I really enjoyed working with them.
So with an exceptional cast, great script, sounds like a phenomenal movie. Are you hoping moviegoers respond in the same way that you see the movie?
Yeah, absolutely. I hope people enjoy the action of it. I hope they enjoy the good effects. I hope they enjoy the tearjerker part, which is just a small smidgen of the movie, my small smidgen of the movie. But I hope people really enjoy the heart and the idea and the family aspect of it too, which is such a strong part of it. So.
Having a family yourself, just saying the family aspect, does that make you glad that you can take your whole family to go see the movie
leave? No, I can't. I'm a little 4.5-year-old kid.
Oh, well, maybe
so
not 4.5-year-old.
The idea of demons and things like that, it's not that. Kids.
But family-oriented, definitely.
Absolutely, absolutely. It's something that I would not be at all ashamed to tell my extended family, go see this film, you know. I think everybody pretty much enjoy it. It's not for all ages. I think, is that okay to say? It's not for all ages? Definitely not for all ages, but I think it's a family-oriented film in the sense that the message is really true and solid, so.
So this isn't your first acting role, we know.
No, it's not.
You've been around for a while.
It might be my last, though. I'm not completely sure. No. Depends on how it turns out. So.
Since you haven't, this wasn't your first role, can you kind of give us an idea of some of the other roles you've had an opportunity to play or bring to life?
Sure. One of the things I really enjoyed was being in a short film that Brian wrote called No Experience Needed, which was a lot of fun. I just played a great character in that. I'll let you track it down and find it and watch it because it was a lot of fun. I've been in soap operas and commercials and a bunch of different little projects. That was another Christian film called Six, a very small part, but it was a fun group as well, a bunch of good, cool Christian people making films. So
I take it you just said good Christian people, so you're Christian, so this gave you an opportunity to bring your faith, I guess,
to
this
absolutely.
Movie. That's not something you get normally in Hollywood.
No, that's definitely not. It is definitely not. I've been kicking around here for a while, and you don't encounter a heck of a lot of Christians. So there are groups, and I'm connected with those groups as well, but it really is... It's different to be a Christian in this industry, you know.
It is.
And I think you really kind of have to stick to your guns and know what you believe and be willing to say no, you know, in a lot of situations.
So. Good to hear you say that. That's not something you see a lot. A lot of opportunity to compromise, a lot of opportunity. So since Brian was the director on this, you already knew him walking into this, project. Did you have to audition? Was there an audition process for you?
Brian said, would you be willing to play the role of Kevin? I said, yeah.
So that was the audition.
I don't know what that is, but yes, whatever it is, I will do that because you're doing it. So, yeah. No, there was, Brian and I have known each other well enough and we know each other's talents well enough to the point where I don't have to audition for him anymore. At least I hope I don't have to audition for him. But I didn't for this one.
You
I was grateful for that because I hate auditioning.
I guess if this one's an Oscar, the next time you may have to audition.
Yeah, I may have to audition for him. You'd be like, all right, after that snide comment, you're going to have to audition this
time. So. Sounds like it's an interesting cast, interesting movie. What do you think will be the response from moviegoers? I think it's going to possibly be released around Easter. Mm-hmm. Do you think it'll be maybe as big as some of the other faith-based movies? We've had some, like, Fireproof, or even The Passion of the Christ, which was probably the biggest.
Yes.
How do you think it'll measure up against some of those?
I don't know. It's a smaller film, a smaller budget than either of those two, but I think the heart is there, and I think the talent is there, I think, unfortunately, what I've run up against is a lot of films that are Christian or faith-based. They don't have... They feel like it's less important to put time and energy into story and into talent involved in the film. And I think that Brian didn't skimp on either of those things. So I think that it's going to be a very, very strong contender. I think that it's going to be a film for a lot of different people, for a very broad audience. And I think people are going to really enjoy it.
Makes me excited already.
Well, good. You should go out and see it.
I definitely plan to. I've gotten a really good glimpse from you and some of the other actors, so I think it's going to be a good one. So, hey, we need to go check it out when it comes out. Well, it was so wonderful talking to you, Mark.
Thank
we enjoyed
you,
it, and we look forward to seeing you in the upcoming movie as well.
Absolutely.
All right, that was Marc Elmer, who is in the upcoming movie Centurion A.D. If you want to see him and the rest of the cast, you'll have to check it out when the movie releases later next year.